In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone, here at Our Lady of Las Vegas Church. Today, we gather for the third Sunday of Ordinary Time. I welcome all of you who join us through social media and the various ways that you reach us. Very happy that we get comments from people that they find us and that they are with us and they pray with us. And so we welcome you here with us today as we come together to meet with Jesus. Let us prepare ourselves for that encounter with Christ in this Eucharist as we first of all acknowledge our sins and as we ask God to grant us mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may abound in good works through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Nehemiah. Ezra the priest brought the law before the assembly, which consisted of men, women, and those children old enough to understand. Standing at the end of the open place that was before the water gate, he read out of the book from the daybreak till midday, in the presence of the men, the women, and those children old enough to understand. And all the people listened attentively to the book of the law. Ezra, the scribe, stood on a wooden platform that had been made for the occasion. He opened the scroll so that all the people might see it, for he was standing higher up than any of the people. And as he opened it, all the people rose. Ezra blessed the Lord, the great God. And all the people, their hands raised high, answered, "Amen, amen." Then they bowed down and prostrated themselves before the Lord, their faces to the ground. Ezra read plainly from the book of the law of God, interpreting it so that all could understand what was read. Then Nehemiah, that is, His Excellency, and Ezra, the priest scribe, and the Levites who were instructing the people said to all the people, "Today is holy to the Lord your God. Do not be sad and do not weep." For all the people were weeping as they heard the words of the law. He said further, "Go, eat rich foods and drink sweet drinks, and allot portions to those who had nothing prepared. For today is holy to our Lord. Do not be saddened this day, for rejoicing in the Lord must be your strength." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, as a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit. Now the body is not a single part, but many. You are Christ's body and individually parts of it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Since many have undertaken to compile a narrative of the events that have been fulfilled among us, just as those who were eyewitnesses from the beginning and ministers of the word have handed them down to us, I too have decided, after investigating everything accurately anew, to write it down in an orderly sequence for you, O most excellent Theophilus, so that you may realize the certainty of the teachings you have received. Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit, and news of him spread throughout the whole region. He taught in their synagogues and was praised by all. He came to Nazareth, where he had grown up, and went, according to his custom, into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed a scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives, and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. And he said to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As you know, we are now in the ordinary time of the church year, indicated by the green-colored vestments that we wear. And this year, we are going to be accompanied primarily by St. Luke and his gospel, or the gospel of Jesus according to St. Luke. And today we read the beginning of his writings, in which he said that he compiled all of the things that happened, the teachings and everything, and he was doing this, all writing it down in an orderly sequence, for someone called Theophilus. Theophilus was a Gentile official that Luke came to know, and he wanted to help him to come to understand and to accept through faith who Jesus was, who Jesus is. And this was the beginning of the Gospel according to St. Luke. Like I said, we're going to be reading from his Gospel this entire year. Luke is going to be our guide. Luke was not a direct apostle of Jesus. He was a physician and a friend of St. Paul. He accompanied St. Paul on many of his journeys. In fact, St. Luke writes much about St. Paul in the Acts of the Apostles. St. Luke is attributed to writing the third synoptic gospel and also the Acts of the Apostles, in which he describes the beginnings of the church, which is what the Acts of the Apostles are about, as Jesus sent them out into the world to go out and make disciples of all nations. And so much of what we know about the early church is thanks to St. Luke and his writings. And today we see him telling us about Jesus coming to Nazareth, to his hometown, and he goes into the synagogue on the Sabbath day, and he unrolls the scroll, and he begins to read the scripture, a passage from the prophet Isaiah. Now remember, Isaiah was a prophet who lived 600 years before Jesus' coming. And Isaiah was one of the great prophets who spoke about the coming Messiah in a very distinct and very clear way. Again, 600 years before Jesus appeared. And he found this passage in which he writes, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I came to bring glad tidings to the poor. He sent me to proclaim liberty to captives, recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Jesus, as the Messiah, comes into this world to do all that and much, much more. You and I are Christian people. We are followers of Christ, even though it is over 2,000 years since Jesus came into this world. But his presence is very much still among us. And just as the scriptures have told us that Jesus would be with us, that he would not leave us orphans, that he would stay with us and be with us always until the end of time. And we believe that. We accept that. That's why we gather on Sunday, especially the Lord's Day, the day of the Lord's resurrection, that we come together as a people of God. And many of you who at this time can't come to Mass, can't assemble in the church, or are at home, you are joining us through this medium, that we are here together celebrating our faith in this liturgy and praising Christ, who is our Messiah, who is the one who came to bring glad tidings to all of us, to all of us who are oppressed, all of us who are pulled down by the troubles and evils of this world. Jesus came to liberate us, as Isaiah said. And as Jesus said, those words that he proclaimed are fulfilled in our hearing. For Jesus truly is the Messiah. And that's the whole point of what Luke wanted to impress upon Theophilus as he's writing these words. And as we will continue reading throughout this year, St. Luke, as well as the other evangelists and all the scripture writers, they want us to know that Jesus truly is the Son of God, that he is the Messiah, and that we are doing well in following him. And so, as we go forth, as we continue reading all that St. Luke presents to us, hopefully that, again, we'll have a deeper awareness, a deeper understanding, a deeper faith in Jesus. For God, as St. John tells us, so loved the world that he gave us his only Son, so that we might have life through him. You know, we gathered together on Sunday, and there were these couple of boys, there were friends who were talking, and they were having a discussion about the days of the week. And one of the boys said to his friend, he says, "Do you know why that Sunday is stronger than Monday?" And his friend says, "Well, maybe because it's the Lord's Day, and maybe because it's the day Jesus rose." And the other friend said, "Yeah, that's true, but Sunday is stronger than Monday because Monday is a weekday." Please join with me now as we profess our faith. I believe in one God,
maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made.
For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the holy giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
God sent his Son, who brought glad tidings to the poor, liberty to captives, sight to the blind, and freedom to the oppressed. Let us gather now our own needs as we humbly ask for God's continuing generosity.
For the church, that we may be evermore aware of the gentle presence of the risen Christ in our midst, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the innocent who suffer the ravages of hatred, terrorism, and war, that there may be an end to violence in our homes, in our communities, and in our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those in authority over others, that they may be models of wisdom, respect, and gentleness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a renewed reverence for all human life, from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that we may be instruments of God's peace in our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may be brought into the presence of the Lord, who made and loves all people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the health of Kim Davis, whom this Mass is offered, and for our own private intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God of love and compassion, look with mercy on your people as we offer our prayers to you, and grant these in all things in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord
accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And and with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering he canceled out our sins. And by his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked for us the gates of heaven. And so, with a company of angels and saints, Father, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we now acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and you are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ's death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to us. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George Leo, our Bishop, Gregory, Auxiliary Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Father, welcome them into the light of your face, and have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Luke, Saint Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you, Father, throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and that we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now at our Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, together let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, Lord, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
O Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. For you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called now to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to life, we may share always glory in your gift. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone, for your being with us today and celebrating this Mass on this third Sunday of Ordinary Time. Give thanks to all of our ministers who assisted at Mass today, to Teresa for being our lector, to Mikhail for manning our cameras, and to our music ministry, Marlene and David. Thank you so much for lifting us up in spirit with music. I hope that all of you are doing well during this time, and that you're not, getting too sick, and hopefully not sick at all. And we pray that this whole thing will be behind us very, very soon. That is our prayer. And we hope that we'll be able to see you here in our church very soon as well. But until that time comes, thank you for joining us. And as we go forth, let us do so now with God's grace and blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is now ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.